Greetings, fellow earthlings. Welcome to Delta Force. Now, Daggerfall has still been somewhat of a game which I'm not getting used to, and I will get to it, but so I'm about to ease myself back into the gaming process, and that is why I've chosen something of a shooter, which isn't exactly a tactical shooter, which is a tactical shooter rather, and not something, like Call of Duty game. I do enjoy Call of Duty games as well, but for now I wanted something a little more intellectual, stimulating, so to speak. So anyway, as for my absence from making videos, what happened was I actually lost my dog, and I had been searching for her for 3 months in the forest and stuff, and after 3 months, after 95 days, we finally found her, so that's a success for us. Anyway, moving on to the mission briefing. Mission: eliminate the mercenary detachment located at Objective Breeze. Execution: you will proceed southwest from your insertion point to a position overlooking Objective Breeze. Eliminate all perimeter patrols, then proceed into the camp and neutralize all enemy forces there. This mission will only be successful if all enemy personnel at the objective are neutralized. Now, just for the sake of clarity, this is a post-gameplay recording. So, yeah. Or rather, I suppose, for the sake of disclosure. Anyway, expected enemy forces. Analysis of satellite imagery provided by the CIA shows the enemy is operating from an abandoned ranch south of the Colombian border. Joint Staff Intelligence, J2, believes that, and now I shall wait until, you know, I decide to scroll further down. So, which is now, good. This is the kind of stuff that happens. Believes that between 10 and 20 mercenaries are currently stationed at this base. The satellite imagery gives no indication of heavy weapons. However, small arms fire is expected to be intense once the attack has been initiated. Allied support. Alpha team will be inserted approximately 130 meters southeast. Point wave 1 is our point, and well, I can only assume that Alpha team is the blue dot underneath point 1. Southeast of your position and will support your left flank. Charlie team will be inserted about 240 meters west of your position. They are tasked with neutralizing the watch station on the ridge north of the ranch and will then proceed to the objective to cover your right flank. Now, spoiler, they fail miserably in this mission. I don't know whether that is my fault or just the way, you know, things went this time around. Situation. After several years of successful government programs to curtail, actually I'll just wait for it later and just explain the situation to you. So basically, I played this level, I had to play it like 3 or 4 times, and there were some of the other problems with the recording. This one I never really realized, I actually put the mic on mute, but yeah, that's what happened. And here we are. And one time I also encountered a bug. Anyway, situation. After several years of successful government programs to curtail coca production, the most powerful drug lord in Peru has hired a large mercenary army to fend off Peruvian drug enforcement enforcement officials. Peruvian, help guard drug shipments bound for the United States and intimidate growers farming coca leaves. In response to Peru's request for assistance with this severe threat to its internal stability, the United States has pledged to assign its most elite force to help defeat the drug lord and his army. The drug lord is using his mercenary army to thwart Peruvian law enforcement and to intimidate the local civilian population. Distribution of this force would be a major blow to the drug lord's ability to conduct his business in Peru. Satellite imagery provided by the Central Intelligence Agency clearly shows one of the mercenary bases operating in Peru. This base, approximately 100 kilometers south of the Colombian border, appears to be a major staging area of the mercenaries. The Joint Forces Special Operations Component Commander, Jeff Sock, has deemed this a priority target. Apologies for my sloppy reading. That was primarily because the screen code that I'm reading from is tiny, and I have no idea how to zoom it in any further. But anyway, here we are. Whatever works, I guess. So, at this point, I had the impression that the Delta Force was something of a, military unit. or rather an army for the United States, but as it turns out, after I did a little bit more of my research,
Alpha to Bravo, in position, waiting for your signal.
Charlie, in position, we'll move on your signal.
King 6 to all elements, you are clear to move in on the objective.
Yeah, so as I was saying, it turns out that the Delta Force is more of a police force, so to speak of. Not exactly police force, like international SWAT. From what I can gather thus far, their activities are mostly counter-terrorism and...
Two shooters in the south
yeah,
tower.
So the activities comprise mostly of counter-terrorism and... hostage rescue and things of that nature. Pretty much what SWAT does on US soil, but Delta Force does on foreign soil, I'm supposing. So yeah, that's an interesting thing. I wonder what the US has for its army. I suppose the answer would be Rangers. So right now I am lying prone on this hill because of a trick that I learned in one of the later games that was inspired by Delta Force.
Alpha 2 is hit! I repeat, Alpha 2 is hit! This is Alpha Team. Tower
so
is clear.
Alpha Team managed to clear the tower, and that is pretty much what we wanted. However, this mission does not really end well for us, and as you can see, you'll see. Yeah, as you can see,
Alpha Team is
already, you know, has been neutralized. They have failed in, you know, neutralizing the enemy, and I have come close, damn close to dying in this mission. In this run through quite a few times myself, and that's one of the reasons you can see me playing a little more passively, playing it safe, laying prone on top of a hill, because right now I'm not really, you know, at risk of getting silhouetted. That's when, you know, the enemy can see your border sort of projecting from on top of a surface which is a hill, but because again it's not really a stealth mission, but the reason I'm laying prone is that bullets tend to fly off, you know, fly above it, greatly reduces your profile, and for whatever reason, the especially at longer ranges, it becomes increasingly more difficult to hit you when you're lying prone closer to the ground, as compared to when you're standing, or, you know, when you're lying prone on top of something, which is something I've noticed about bullet dynamics. I don't know whether this game has any or not, but yeah, so it's just one of the things that I'm doing, and thus far it seems to be succeeding. I mean, one of the things that I noticed about this game was that they did make the sound design really well. They have got all the sounds, you know, like the whizzing of the bullets as they like fly past you, and that's Charlie 2 right there, I'm assuming, because Charlie 1 is already down. But unfortunately, his life is also going to be quite short-lived, because that one person that you hear shooting, yeah, that's not Charlie 2, that's an enemy, and he's basically trying to hit us. The enemies are a little dumb in this game, but you need to be careful, because if you act too aggressively, excuse me, if you act too aggressively, you will die. However, if you act too passively, there are chances that, you know, your friends may die, and you'll be left all alone. So that is something I think happened in this case here, because I think I died twice already, and somebody just fired shots at me, and I'm trying to figure out who it is, and thank God there are traces here. But at any rate, like I said, I am completely alone at this point of time, and Charlie 2 is dead. Charlie 2 is dead. I'm literally just, you know, hanging on by my own self. One of the things which I don't understand, of course, I mean, it is artistic license, and they do have to, you know, find a way to rationalize everything. But one of the things that I don't understand is, why is it that Bravo 1, that is I, when I die, the game keeps going, but when I, you know, sorry, the game, it's game over, it's like an instant game over, my friends don't accomplish the mission, but when my friends die, I get to keep living. That seems a little unfair, isn't it? But anyway, I guess that's just how you, you know, put in a game over condition in a single player game. So yeah, not to, you know, think too much into it. Now this specific mission is pretty simple, as you had already read it in the briefing. It's mostly about eliminating everybody here, and that is the primary challenge that I'm facing right now. I almost did it the first time around, but this always seem to be like a few stragglers here and there, which are super difficult to find. And the first time around, I actually had every single one of my soldiers. Now, as you just noticed here, you'll also notice that The magazine, I mean, I actually reloaded, but it didn't show any reload animation. It just, it just played the sound and gave it a little bit of gap before I could fire anything. But yeah, speaking of, that's the last soldier that I'm trying to locate. It's right in that shed there. There are a lot of cuts because I had been running around aimlessly like a headless chicken. Because despite 3 years in voluntary service, it's actually not military service, just, you know, like a voluntary final line of defense, you guys can look it up, it's called the NCC. So after, you know, all my years there, I still don't know how to read a map. So yeah, that's on me. So yeah, the final guy I concluded is probably hiding in the shed because sheds aren't marked on the map. So right now, while I'm wondering what I can do to, you know, take this guy out, I realize that, oh yeah, this gun has another barrel grenade launcher. So I decided to use that. But what was I saying before that? It does have a parabolic drop. I mean, projectiles like a grenade do have a parabolic, you know, drop arc in this game. That fell right inside, but it did no damage, so... Yeah, I shot beyond the house, and it's mission complete for us.
King 6 to all elements, objective secured. Move to primary extraction point.
Huh, mission debriefing. 12 kills, congratulations on your successful mission. Bravo team, the elimination of that base will send a message to their mercenaries and their drug lord bosses that they must cease their operations or be eliminated. Documents found within the destroyed base point to the location of one of the drug lord's supply caches and also suggest the location of an airfield being used by the mercenaries as a transshipment point for weapons and other supplies. Now, there are more missions in the Peru chapter, and we'll get to them slowly. Until then, this is the test video. I will see you guys later. Farewell. Take care, fellow earthlings. Or wait, was it? Take care, farewell, fellow earthlings. Sorry, it's been a while since I've done this. And yeah, that's my cue.